All right, we in here with the blue green turbo warp deck, which I'm gonna keep this hand a land and a seer of visions. It could get a bit dicey, but I'm willing to gamble. As for this deck, it's definitely a bit underpowered for the two mans. I'm fine with that. Like, it's a trade-off. This deck is different. It's sweet and it's new. So I don't care. I've been enjoying rocking this, winning maybe half my matches, maybe a little bit less, and I've been totally fine with that. Okay, let's keep the breeding pool only. Actually, we should have kept a fourth land. Oh well. We should be okay. The Seer of Vision should find another one. But yeah, I mean, it's just a sweet deck. It's really a sweet deck. It's all right. I mean, we'll see how good we can make it. I mean, I don't think there's too much room left for me to develop this list. Pretty tight. But ooh, well, we have a brew off, so this is gonna be a fun one. For sure. Okay, let's explore. And then we're gonna Serum Visions. We're gonna look for we're gonna look for another land, which we had just put to the bottom. But it seems like it should work just fine. I'm gonna keep a land to use with our Cobra. That way, next turn we could potentially go a little bit crazy. Okay, the opponent has not used their Zombie Infestation. I'm not really sure what the play is. It could be a Squee deck. It could be Treasure Hunt. It could be. Okay, well, it's a Hack On deck, I see, or something like that. Vengevine, okay. And pretty aggressive. Not at all wanting to Jace up. It seems like not what we want. So we could play the Cobra and we could Time Warp. I'm trying to think if there's any way that we're going to be able to, like, next turn we could, no, we're not gonna be able to Jace. Next turn we could Jace and Cryptic. And this turn we can Vapor Snag, so let's do that. Blue. And I guess we might as well snag now. Could have waited. I mean, there wasn't really a reason to do it now because we actually have fewer options, but it looks like we have more options because we have more mana represented. I don't think it made a huge difference either way. I mean, I guess we could have snagged our Cobra, and we probably would have wanted to do that, so that's real. Okay, take a hit. Depending on what we do with our Cryptic, the game will play out differently. There's a remand. I think I'm just gonna ship the turn. Game plan is to use Cryptic to bounce the zombie on this turn. Take a hit from Hack On. One, two, three, four, return. Draw a card. Okay, well, there's an explore. Opponent can make another zombie, or maybe those two cards are good. I'm gonna use the Misty to. Well, I guess I maybe regret that. Here's a pretty interesting tension with the deck. Like, if we pull this breeding pool right now, then we have Scalding Tarn with only one island. So it's something to be aware of like actually running out of fetchable lands with this deck. So I'm gonna keep that in mind. There's a Garruk, which is great. We could Garruk and then plus and then Jace. But then we'd probably be able to keep one Planeswalker and not die. So I'm all right with that. We're likely to keep a Planeswalker and to not die. So it seems good. Game plan with this Jace is don't want to give the opponent extra cards at all because it would mean maybe Vengevine coming back or extra half a zombie. Five loyalty would be nice, but kind of want the opponent to kill the Jace and leave us with the Garrick. So if it's a bit exposed, that's fine by me. Okay, there goes an abrupt decay. All right, well, it's unlikely we're gonna die this turn. If the opponent kills Garrick, then we can draw. Ooh, in position. Opponent gets to kill one of the planeswalkers, but actually probably takes remand here. Ooh, takes the Jace, which is interesting. I guess implying that Jace is gonna get killed. I mean, the opponent could also go to our face. Okay, weird. Kills. Oh, I see. He's attacking for the most possible loyalty. Okay, that seems totally fine. Okay, there's a Cryptic, which is a great draw. One, two, three. Let's just untap a couple lands. Explore the this stuff or something. Okay, three, four, five. I guess we'll time warp. And then probably use the Cryptic to tap and draw a card. Most likely, trying to chain off a little bit. Looking for, I mean, we don't have a treetop, which is a little bit awkward. We also have this remand, which is incredibly dead. I guess I maybe could have tried to combo it with Explore. Hopefully the opponent tries to cast a spell at some point. May or may not happen. I guess I'm gonna tap and draw. We could bounce the zombie. And then we would trade and that would just come back. So I'm just gonna tap. Don't really want to bounce the hack on because it would mean the opponent can make another zombie and then replay it. Okay, there's another Cryptic, which is nice. Just buy us a little bit of time while continuing to tick Garrick, make three threes to trump the zombies. Opponent plays a grave crawler, which is fine because it allows us to cycle, which is huge. Okay. Oh, but then it gives Vengevine back. That was really bad. Super problematic. Okay, well, we're gonna have to combo somehow. There's another Garrick. Okay. Let's make another 3-3. 3-4, play a Garrick. I'm pretty sure we have basics left. Okay. Get the island. Now we have a blank Scalding Tarn. We can make another 3-3, which seems good. And then I think tap draw, and then we're gonna be pretty close to winning. We could even let the opponent attack, maybe. I'm not sure if these matter that much. We can trade with the Vengevine. I mean, we can use Cryptic to bounce a zombie, trade with the hack on, trade with the Vengevine. I think we want a tap draw. Seems like the play to me. This gives us an opportunity to just win if we draw like a Snapcaster or another way to take an extra turn. Okay, Snapcaster. We can snap Time Warp, and that should do it. Let's see if we can pull that off. A little bit vulnerable to graveyard hate right now. Time Warp. And let's take an extra turn. Serum Visions, might as well. There's a remand, Jace. It's fine. Make it 3-3. We have another turn too. Garrick takes over. Okay, we won. Nice. As for sideboarding, Rest in Peace seems pretty good. That is gonna make our Snapcasters bad. And then I guess we're willing to take extra damage. And then I think we'd want Worm Coil here. It seems like it would take over. And we're gonna need to cut something. So I'm gonna go down on remands. We'll try this out. No snaps is gonna make this tough, but rest in peace is, could be just a huge beating.